In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey there, welcome to my channel, Dr. Shinu here. I hope you guys are well, staying at home, safe at home. Today we are going to talk about how I lost my weight during MBBS.
नहीं, मुझे मजाक नहीं उड़वाना अपनी चीज का, मैं नहीं बताऊंगा.
Just kidding, Baba. We are not even getting there. Today I thought of talking about what all books I read or referred to during my MBBS, including all the practical books as well. Before getting into the video, I would give you guys a pro tip.
Wait a minute. Who are you?
So during MBBS, there are various subjects. So for all the subjects, we have so many different books. You won't even believe. So before purchasing any book for a particular subject, I would suggest you to go to your library first and explore. You are supposed to read a few topics from different books and get to know it by yourself whether which book is suitable for you or not. Many times what happens is you get to understand from a simpler book and you don't even understand a single word from the standard book. So we all are different, so I believe you need to find your own book.
5 minutes later.
So these are just my suggestions. I am not forcing you to read any of them. So without wasting any time, let's just get into the video fast, because trust me guys, it's going to be a long video. Let's just start with the first year. For first year we have anatomy, and for anatomy what I read was B.D. Chaurasia. Of course, there are other, this is volume 1 and there are total 3 volumes. I have other 2 as well, you can see. So I did not read Grey's. Actually Grey's is the standard book for anatomy, but I believe you cannot complete whole of Grey's in the first year itself, because we literally just get 8-9 months before the university exams. So I could not take that risk. We have total 2 more subjects. We can call them sub-subjects in anatomy, that is embryology and histology. For those subjects, I referred to in the BHC. Actually, I'm not having those books right now with me. I have given them to my juniors, and there are many other books as well which I am not having right now with me. So I'll make sure to attach a photograph here on the screen. And there was this one more book by Vishram Singh. I've read that for NeuroAnat. Now let's move to our second subject, that is physiology. For physiology, I read Sarvalinga. It's a heavy book. Actually, there is one more book by A.K. Jain. You can also refer to that book. I refer to A.K. Jain for my practicals. And it's an amazing book. Now for the third subject, that is biochemistry, I refer to Satyanarayan. You can also refer to Vasudevan. Both the books are amazing. And for dissection, Cunninghams are a must. I remember during our first year, we were not even allowed to enter the dissection hall without Cunninghams. So that was it for our first year guys. Let's just move to our second year. For second year, we have pharmacology. And for pharmacology, I read It's a beautiful book, you must read it. And also, don't refer to Shanbag. It's like a key book. There are no proper explanation given in that book. So, I will not suggest you to read that book. And during my internship, I got my hands on Govind Raipal's book. This is also a beautiful book. But you are supposed to read the KDL party, and after that you can read this for solving MCQs and stuff. So that was for pharmacology. Let's move to our second subject, that is pathology. For pathology, obviously, why not Robbins? It's a beautiful book, but again, I believe the general pathology is very beautifully written in Robbins as compared to the systemic pathology. For systemic pathology, I refer to the Hirsch moment. I'll just show you. This is the Hirsch moment. The diagrams are beautifully given in this book. You can read this also for general pathology. But Robbins is a beautiful book and no one can deny the fact. For microbiology, I read Anant Narayan. It's nice. And there is a small book called Baveja for parasitology. For forensic, I read Gautam Viswas. It's a beautiful book, trust me. At times, I feel it's better than Reddy. Because Reddy is a huge book and for a short subject like forensic, I would not waste my time on it. In third year, we have ophthalmology. And for ophthalmology, I read Khurana. It's a nice book. And for ENT, I read Dhingra. I don't really like ENT much. I read it anyway. During third year, we have a major subject called PSM. PSM is Preventive and Social Medicine. For that, obviously Park. I still enjoy reading Park. I don't know why everyone says it's so boring to read Park, but I love it. Let's move to final year, which is the most dangerous of all. We have a very short period of time and we have so many portions to cover and it's really hard to decide what to read and what not to read. During final year, first subject is medicine. For medicine, I read Archit Buller. Many of my batchmates who were reading some other books, many of them were also referring to Harrison's, Davidson's. But I believe it's nearly impossible to complete that. And if you are saying you can complete whole of your Harrison during final year, then you must be kidding me. Because that's not possible. So in Archit Buller, you can even find tables directly from Davidson. And so I believe it's enough to pass the final year and it's enough to clear PG exams as well. Another major subject of final year is surgery. And for surgery, I read Manipur. I love this book because, let me show you how cute it is. See, I don't know why I find it cute. That's why I read Manipur. There were my batchmates who were reading SRB also. It's also a nice book, but I like this one. Then there is OBS and Gyne. For OBS, I read Datta. It's more than enough. And for Gyne, Shaw. I believe Shaw is the Bible for gynecology. It's very beautifully written and all the grading of the cancers are also correct. So I will go with Shaw for gynecology. In final year, there is pediatrics also. For pediatrics, obviously Ghar. It's a nice book. Everything is well written, well described with diagrams and flowcharts. So it's easy to just go through it once. Now let's move to the practical books. During final year, we have 50% marks for the theory and 50% marks for the practical. I believe it's wise to choose a good book for practical as well. So for medicine, what I read was Kundu. Kundu is a nice book. All the cases and explanations are written in it in a beautiful manner. I love that book. Then for pediatrics, Cheda is enough. You can also refer to Meherban Singh. It's also nice. And then let's move to surgery. For surgery, what I read was Estas. You should read it. And for OBS and Gyne, I did not really read any practical books because I think Datta and Shaw are enough for the practical as well. You don't need to refer to other books. That was it for today, guys. If you still have any doubts, you can definitely comment down below and ask me directly. Please share this video with as many medical friends as you have. Please share this video in your WhatsApp groups. And thank you so much for watching. I will definitely see you in my next video. Ta-da!